Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. This is All The Tech and this is a quick review for Dell monitor P2419H. I hope this will help you make your purchase decision. So, the main features. This is a full HD monitor with a 16:9 aspect ratio and a 60 Hz refresh rate. It's an IPS panel and I must say it's really good. I mean, Dell monitor panels are always famous for their price performance balance. This monitor does not support USB-C inputs and has no USB-C ports. We will look at the ports in detail in this video in just a minute. There are also no built-in speakers in this. If you're looking for a 4K display, you should look for 27 inches or a higher size monitors. This is 24 inches and for that full HD is good enough. Plus, it saves you some money. Now this model costs about 200 euros in the Netherlands and I think is priced reasonably well considering what it offers. This is one of the most popular models of the Dell Professional series. Quickly jumping on to what's included in the box. The paperwork as usual. A Dell DisplayPort cable. A USB 3 upstream cable. The cables for power and the monitor stand of course. So here is the monitor all unpacked. It is a very nice design. It's not too heavy, little bit less than 5 kgs. The finishing is nice, the color is good, the quality of materials is good. Let me quickly fix it up and let's see the detail. So the monitor is all set up now and it's a really nice monitor. I mean, the monitor is completely adjustable, very good for ergonomics. You can move it up and down as you wish. You can tilt it front and back as per your convenience. And you can also rotate it to any angle you want without having to move the monitor. The cable management is also good. It's given in the stand. Plus, I also noticed that the quality of the monitor stand and the plastics used is much better quality than what I had on the monitor on the right side. So, yeah, that definitely makes a difference. I like this one much better. So here is a closer look at the ports. So at the bottom we have the power port, we have a HDMI port, we have a Dell display port, a VGA port, a USB 3 upstream cable port, and two USB-A ports on the top. Good enough. But we also have two USB-A ports on the left side of the monitor. This comes in really handy if you connect this cable to the monitor and on the other side there's a USB-A connection which goes to your laptop or computer. Once you connect this cable, all the four USB ports become functional and it comes in really handy compared to the amount of devices that we want to connect, like your mouse, your USB keyboard, your camera, everything. This really helps. I did not have this in my old Dell monitor. To control the monitor functions like display, brightness, input port, you have the buttons located at the bottom of the monitor. The power button is fine, but the other buttons are a bit tedious to use. I don't like them. I like to control them with the software, but I'll show you the functions quickly. You can select the mode of display, you can select the input, the brightness, the contrast, and here are all the options. Since I am using a Mac, I use an app called Brightness Slider. You can download it. I can leave a link in the description. Yeah, this is very handy. You can control the brightness of the monitor using this app. It works perfectly fine. If you are using a Windows machine, Dell provides Dell Display Manager. You can download it and it will let you select all the functions. Brightness, contrast, input source, and you can also split the screen as per your convenience. If you would like to do that, yeah, that comes in pretty handy for Dell monitors. I can leave a link for that also in the description. So final verdict, I think this is a great monitor. If you are looking for a basic monitor with a good display and also within a budget, I think you should go for it. This Dell Professional Series monitor is one of the most used monitor. It has the ideal size. It's not too big. It's also not too small. And yeah, it serves all purpose. So that's it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope it was helpful for you. And if you have any questions about the monitor, feel free to post them in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you guys in the next video.